Today we are going to create a registration and login system that has email verification and password reset feature using PHP 8 and Symfony 6. So please ensure that you have a database already set and you have Composer installed and you have an email credential that will be set. Please check the description for relevant links. We have a great task ahead, so let's get started by opening the terminal and starting new Composer project by creating Composer. Create project, a Symfony skeleton, and let's name the project a Symfony login. All right, now Symfony going to install minimum dependencies that are required to start a Symfony application. We step into that created directory that is the Symfony login, and let's install the required dependencies using Composer require twig, the templating system for Symfony, the ORM object relation mapping database, the security. We need the mailer, the maker that allows us to generate code using the terminal. We need the form, the Symfony form system, the validator. Let's also install the Symfony cast reset password bundle and the Symfony cast as well verify email bundle. All right, now let's open our favorite editor. For me, this for PHP, of course, is PhpStrom. I have the storm command that open PhpStrom for current project. All right, first thing we need to do to open our .env file and configure our database and email credentials. For the mail DSN, I use a free service that called MailTrap. It is used for email testing. So here I create a Radian account and the credentials. I can find the host, the username and the password that are required. So I'm going to copy the username and the password. All right, let's open now the terminal and create a user object with PHP bin console make user. This will create user class. We can let everything per default. All right, let's use the maker command to create the login form using PHP bin console make auth. We want login form and our authenticator name should be app authenticator. We just let per default everything else. Now let's create new controller and let's secure that controller using PHP bin console make controller, and let's call the controller admin. So only admin should have access to this controller. All right, so we already have a lot of code generated, so let's go to our admin controller. As we see here, already the path admin there. Now let's secure this route and this controller using the abstract controller method, that is this deny and let's grant it, and we give it the is authenticated fully role in order to access this route. Now let's remove the render parameter here and we just let only the twig templating system is returned. Let's go into that new file. Let's just remove everything and we put an h1 that tells hello. Let's give the user email by app user and email. We also can add a lookout link here using an a tag, lookout, app lookout, and let's say only just lookout. All right, let's open our security controller. And as we can see, we have already commented code that can be useful for us. Let's go down and comment this part and unseat here the target route we want to redirect to the admin. Next step, we need to create registration form. We can also use the maker command. In the terminal, we put PHP bin console and make registration form, and this will create our registration form. We can let everything per default as it is. Yes, oh, here default does not work. We need to enter an email, so let's put just mailer at mailer.de, the name mailer boot, and we let the rest per default. All right, now we have a lot of code have been generated. Now if we look to the controller, we will find the new registration controller that have all the code we need. We can do the same thing as we did in the security controller, the first two line here. So we can also put this there to ensure that already registered user does not see the registration page. And then we can go down here and everything is created for us. We have one to do here and we need to redirect to the app admin the route that we already created. So let's open the register template here, the register HTML. We want to add a friendly message that tells the user, do you have already an email? Click here to log in. So we add an A tag to the app login as is written here. Let's go and let's do the same for the login page. We can find it into the security, the login, and we do the same here under the form. We want to ensure the same thing for the login page. Just we say, you don't have an account? Click here to register. That is simple. All right, our templating now is finished. Security controller finished. The registration controller finished. And we already created a protected route that is the admin controller. We can still do one thing there. We can redirect users that still didn't verify their email to a page that say, please verify emails. We can do this directly now. So first, let's get our user. Get user. And let's ensure that our IDE understands that this user is the app entity user. And this is now is a good opportunity to use the new PHP 8 match feature. And we say the user is verified. And let's say if true, if our user verified, then this render and we put the admin. All right. And if false, then we don't redirect to the admin, but to please verify email. We still didn't create this template, so we can just create it now in the template. All right, we have already code generated from PhpStrom. We put an H1 and let's say, please verify your email. All right, let's go back now. Let's clean up this. Now we need to go to our authenticator. And we can find it in the security, the app authenticator. Normally, we can find here a to-do. We have a task to do. So we can just remove this error. And here, let's instead of some route, let's do the admin. So to ensure that after successful login, the user should be redirected to this route. And finally, we need to create our database structure and tables. We can use the maker command for this. So we can open the terminal PHP bin console. Console doctrine, and we use the schema create to generate our database. Database is already created. At this point, theoretically, everything should be working. So we need to start a Symfony server here using the Symfony command serve. And let's go to the local host, the port 8000. And to the login page. All right, login page there now ready. So let me put any email like xxx at yotyotyot.de and let's put any password 123456 and let's sign in. We should not be signed in. Invalid credential. Nice message. All right, let's go to the register. We have click here to register. This is nice. And let's put our email xxx at yotyotyot.de and let's put 123456 as password and let's agree to the term and let's click on the register and let's see what happened now. And we have please verify your email. This is nice. Everything seems to be working. But now let's check our mail trap and we have an email. This is beautiful. Let's see. Let's go here and click on confirm my email and hello xxx at yotyotyot.de. So this seems to be working. One more feature we still need to do and is the reset password feature. Let's open new terminal and use the PHP bin console make reset password. And let's just leave everything per default. All right, we need the email here. So let's put say mailer at domain.de, mailer boot. All right, now all logic that is responsible for resetting password is created. We need to change the route that after a successful reset where it go and we can just look for the app home and reset password. We already have this here and let's put the app admin. Next, let us, as it says here, that we need to migrate our database and let's put make migration. Yes. And let's finally copy this PHP bin console and let's migrate now to the latest. Yes. Yes. All right. Now we need to add reset password link into the login page. So we go to the template, to the login here. We want to show a friendly message that says, did you forget your password? Click here to reset. And this is will be the function of this link. All right, so what we are waiting, our server is still working. Let's go Refresh the page. Let's look out. Hope that work. All right, we are into the home. Let's go to the login page. All right, we have, did you forget your password? Click here to reset. Let's click here to reset the password. And our email was xxx@yotyotyot.de. And let's do it. So now give us a friendly message that say if your email exists, then a link should be sent to your mail. So let's go to our email, and your password reset request just arrived now. And let's click on that. Let's click on that password reset. Let's do the new password is A, and the same A, and save password. Okay, so let's again try to log in with 6 mal A. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and let's see if it works. And we are already in the protected route, and that's it. Ladies and gentlemen, this was how to create registration and login system using Symfony 6 and PHP 8. I will commit and push this repository so that you can clone it and download it. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.